واتقوا الله إن الله خبير بما تعملون. Brothers and sisters, as you know and you are aware now, after a couple of announcements that I've made during my nightly lectures, that the Jamaat or the community or your leadership in this country, in conjunction with the Africa Federation and the local Jamaat, have taken on themselves the task of taking out the first census of the Jamaat and the headcount of the members of this community. So we are to be supporters of that initiative for the following reason that I will mention before you, and I will not take much of your time. However, before I do so, I want to go back a little bit in history to corroborate the fact that it is not something new that was not founded in the early days of Islam or at the time of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, so that people would not be taken back and say this is, for example, an initiative that we've never heard of or we were never used to before. No, rest assured that the first census was ordered by the Prophet himself sallallahu alaihi wasallam to assess the number of Muslims for defensive purposes. In a hadith narrated on the authority of Hudhayfa ibn al-Yaman, he says, we were with the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam when he said, count for me how many people profess Islam. So we asked, O Messenger of Allah, are you afraid of our negligent of support to you? You're in doubt that we will not come to your support, that we will not come to your defense, while we are between 600 to 700 strong in number? He replied, you never know. Perhaps you may be faced with tribulation later on. So be prepared, is what the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is trying to say. Don't always be overtaken by your strength, whether it is by wealth or by numbers, because challenges will always come your way. So be ready. And we did indeed, then Hudhayfa said later on, he says, and we did indeed face tribulation to the point where a man of us wouldn't even pray except secretly. To that extent, people were challenged to some extent in their life. Other hadith report a higher population of 1500, which shows that either the census was taken multiple times as the community grew, or that the higher figures reported all Muslims, including men and women and children, and the lower number tallied only men specifically. The reason for this census, brothers and sisters, was to record the number of able-bodied men for the Muslim defense reasons at critical battles such as Uhud and the trench Al-Khandaq. This proves that the taking of a census and the analysis of demographics is practiced or is a sunnah by the Prophet himself sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and upheld by the sacred law when there is a need for it. Therefore, for a visionary and progressive community aspiring to ascend to higher level of development in spirituality, education, academia, economy, health, and housing planning, it is important to have a database of the community for effective and long-term planning of the resources needed and the privileges at hand. In this competitive climate, we cannot afford to go forward irrationally, meaning without a plan and information. Therefore, census is crucial, or is a crucial element in planning for short, medium, and long terms. To utilize our resources effectively, we need to have valid data, and only a census can provide this. Also, it is important to update the data regularly, otherwise it will be meaningless. This census will be spearheaded by our brother Al-Haj Shiraz Biwalji on the 21st of the holy month of Ramadan. I can't overemphasize how important your participation and cooperation in this project, since it is for the benefit of the whole Jamaat at large. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. اللهم صلي على محمد عبدك ورسولك ومبلغ رسالاتك أفضل ما صليت وباركت وترحمت وتحننت وسلمت على أحد من عبادك وأنبيائك ورسلك.